The perfect drink.
The perfect drink.
The perfect drink.
The perfect drink.
The Perfect Drink is a podcast that combines amazing cocktails with the kind of infinite wisdom that can only come from a lifetime of poor decisions. So take a journey with everybody's favorite bartender. We can make some drinks, have some laughs, and who knows, you might even learn a thing or two. See you soon.
Well, everybody, it's old HRK here, everybody's favorite bartender, and it is time for another episode of The Perfect Drink. So it's day after Mother's Day, so happy Mother's Day. You tell your mom I said happy Mother's Day, if I didn't already tell her. And then, I don't know, you know, it's exciting. Speaking of mothers, two, three weeks ago, I did the show with Jenna, the dating guru she co-hosted. And I saw on Facebook her mom posted, like Jenna posted a link. And then her mom commented, I tried to watch it, but that guy says the F word so much I couldn't take it. So, I don't know. I can tell you right now, today's is about crazy exes, so I'm probably going to fucking use the F word a lot. But I'll have Jenna back on sometime, and I'll try my best to do an F word free show. That'll be the theme. No F words out of old HRK. And then, yeah, I don't know. My, you know, my mom, she's down in old Tejas, so I didn't get to see her. But, you know, we did the Happy Mother's Day, love you stuff. Every Mother's Day just makes me wish that I could sing like a 1990s R&B singer, so I could sing that Mama song from Boys to Men. I could just call my mom and belt it out, but that would be the opposite of a gift if I tried to do it with my current pipes. What else? I don't know, man. You know, fucking got a show coming up at the Forge in Joliet. So I'll give you more information on that as it approaches. And then I saw Willard Wilcox yesterday at Anthony's in Joliet. He'll be there every Sunday at 1 o'clock all summer long. Hashtag Kid Rock. So fucking A, man, go check out Willard Wilcox on a Sunday fun day if you're bored. It's a great bar. They got this cool outside area that's like it's like inside, but it's like an atrium. I don't know. It's dope. So also, I just said dope, so I feel like that if that can't get your ass out of the house on a Sunday, I don't know what can. So yeah, like I said, today's topic of the show is crazy girlfriends. And what I did was I developed a test, a crazy girlfriend test. There's 10 questions, and then, you know, your score applies to whatever. So fuck, let's get into ripping shots, man. All right, music brought to you by Willard Wilcox. We're gonna be shooting Jack Honey again this week. I just got this bottle; I gotta get rid of it. Ashley likes it though, so I probably shouldn't do Jack Honey because she enjoys that. So I'm being kind of selfish. Maybe on the way out, I'll do this Dubliner instead. I was going to do a shot for every question that I've experienced on this test, but it occurred to me I'd do fucking 11 shots. So, I'm not saying I can't do 11 shots, but I got to work today. So I figured I'd take it easy. So let's put this first shot down. We'll go through the questions. I'll do a shot at the end. All right. The crazy girlfriend test. Here we go. Ladies, keep track of your score. There's 10 questions. Question one, have you ever thrown a blunt object at your boyfriend? I can tell you I've dated several girls that have fucking thrown blunt objects at me. Present girlfriend included. Fucking hit me too, right in the face. Unbelievable. Couldn't fucking hit the broadside of a barn if her fucking life depended on it with like a baseball. You know, never went to gym class, but she can sure as fuck nail me from, you know, 25 feet out with a fucking candelabrium or whatever the fuck that thing was she threw at me. There I am with the F word again. Sorry, Jenna's mom. Number two, made a scene at your boyfriend's job. Obviously that's happened to me. I've had girls like call. You ever listen? If you're the type of girl that will call your man's job just to like fuck with him, fucking one of the Be Positive guys I heard on a podcast told the story about this man's woman got him fired from a fucking job. Like she either ratted him out on something or like told a lie about him, and they had to fucking cut the guy loose. Like, that's your man. And then she, it's not like she, they broke up. She just got him fired because she's being a fucking asshole. I feel like that's like a legit white girl thing. Like, I feel like I've never dated a black girl, but I feel like a black girl doesn't do shit. They want their man working. I feel like black girls are a lot less crazy. And like I said, I've never dated one, but I just feel like they're good at, like, if they're done with you, they're just like, fuck you, man. See you later. They don't take any shit. White girls are fucking stupid. Anyways, made a senior boyfriend's job. Number three, dumped a drink on your boyfriend in public. That's happened to me on several fucking occasions. Ashley did not do that one to me, but we got an argument once. There's and the Two Guys in Tequila podcast, there's an episode called Ryan Gets Dumped. And I can tell you right now, I could tell in her face she wanted to dump a fucking Bloody Mary on me that day. But she held back. What a gal. God, what a gal. Okay. Called your boyfriend's mom to tell on him. Now this is girls call. I've had this happen to me, and I just feel like my mom's always like, yeah, well, you know, that's Ryan. I don't know what to tell you, you fucking dummy. Okay, flirted with another guy to make your boyfriend jealous. I feel like that's the most mild one. But it's really like measured by how hard you flirt, like what levels you go to like, you know, I mean, I don't know, but that's childish. Fucking grow up. And if a girl, I mean, I don't know, if a girl does that shit in front of me, I don't know. I shouldn't act. I don't. It depends on how much I like the girl, but I hate when it's dumb. Fucking grow up, ladies. Guys will never do that. I would never flirt with a girl in front of Ashley on purpose to make her jealous. That's just a good way to get like create a double homicide. You know what I mean? She'll stab the poor girl that I'm flirting with, unbeknownst to her that anything's even happening. And then I'll get stabbed, you know, trying to like pull her off the girl that she's stabbing any fucking ways. Made a fake Facebook or Instagram account to spy on your boyfriend. I've got like fucking three girlfriends that have fake accounts currently and are fucking trolling me. Fucking assholes. Faked sick to keep your boyfriend from going out. That's I've had that happen, and it's dumb, and I'll tell a story about it to prove how I knew she was faking. Looked at your boyfriend's phone without him knowing. That's the most common one. Like, I did a TikTok with this quiz, and then I posted it on Facebook. So like, I've got a bunch of responses, and we'll talk about that in a minute. But that was the most common one that girls said they did, and every one of them was like, it was totally worth it because I caught him, blah blah blah. And I mean, that's fine, but I can tell you, like, Ashley just threw my phone and like caught me, but she didn't really catch me because I wasn't really doing anything. She just saw stuff she didn't like, but it wasn't like I was like, hey, meet me at the hotel. You know what I'm saying? So I don't know. I just feel like that's a dangerous one. I did an episode about that. I'm not going to talk too much about it because I just did an episode about let me see your phone. And then number 10, and this one's worth 2 points. If you've ever worked as a nurse, you get 2 points. And if you've ever worked as a nurse, you've done at least 3 of these other things. And so many women commented like, I just got 2 points because I'm a nurse, but I've never done any other things. I'm like, yeah, you haven't, bitch. Sure. Lying ass. But here's the thing, man. It's amazing how many women said that they had zero. I've never done any of those things. Like, well, let's review the scoring system. So if your score was zero, you're a liar, and you're probably the craziest of all. Zero is probably the highest score, because if you're lying, you're probably fucking ultra crazy. You know what I mean? So technically, 11 is not the highest score. Zero is. If you get a zero, you're the most crazy bitch there is. 1 to 3. If you've scored a 1 to 3, you probably just never really liked anyone that much, because if you've only done like 3 of these things, you know, that's not that crazy. You probably never loved someone enough to get super fucking crazy. 4 to 6, you're just a normal girl. You know what I mean? You're an everyday chick, pretty fucking crazy, not dangerous, just crazy. And then 7 to 11, you love so hard. These girls love the hardest. These are the girls that just love their fucking man so much that they will murder them, because if they can't have them, nobody can. So yeah, if you're 7 to 11, then, you know, here's to you, gals. Let's rip this second shot. Like I said, this next time we're going to do Dubliner. This is caramel. I don't know how you say it. Do you say caramel or caramel? I feel like if you say caramel, you're a jagoff, but what the fuck do I know? Cheers to all you crazies out there. Love you guys. And yeah, so it's amazing. So I did the TikTok and I did the Facebook post, and so many girls were like going hard on like, I've got a zero. I've never done any of these. And I just think there's no fucking way. And finally, one girl on TikTok posted like, you bitches are all liars. Everyone's done at least one of these things. You guys are full of shit. And I was just like, thank you so much. Because coming from a girl, at least, that, you know, it's easy for me to make a test like this and I just sound like I'm bitter or whatever. You know what I mean? I sing my ex's praises all the time. Every girl I've ever dated is a great girl. And it's funny because a lot of them I've heard say, like, I've heard like on the streets that they'll say that like I make them crazy. It's not, they're not crazy. It's me, which, you know, I mean, nobody's better at fucking deflecting responsibility for their actions than a fucking woman. But, you know, they'll say like, I'm going to tell you right now, like every girl I've dated is at least a little crazy. Except a couple that like, I've just gone on I'll date a girl for like 3 weeks. You know what I mean? Like if I have like a long single run and I'm dating a lot, I'll have like a 3 week girl that I'm seeing. And sometimes they don't seem crazy. But like I said, everyone's still putting their best foot forward in 3 weeks. You know what I mean? Those bitches sleep in their makeup still. Oh, fuck, man. Let's make this cocktail. Today's cocktail is called Ya Bacon Me Crazy. And it's a bacon-infused vodka drink. I already poured the vodka because I wanted to soak the bacon in it because I didn't buy bacon-infused vodka. I use Dillinger vodka around here. I don't know if you know about Dillinger vodka, but it's smooth and delicious. Dillinger vodka, join the gang. So I have some Dillinger already in the shaker, and I had bacon in it. I pulled the bacon out before the start of the show. And, you know, so let's get in with the rest of the ingredients. So you're going to start with about 2 ounces of Dillinger. You're going to do a dabble of maple syrup. Today we're going to be using Aunt Maple's original syrup. I believe that's Aldi generic brand. That's how I fucking live my life. And then you're just going to put in some apple juice. You can use apple cider, but I just like fucking apple juice. Maybe, I don't know, a couple ounces. It don't matter because the ice has been melting a little bit, so it's probably a little watered down, but that's all right. We're going to get this thing done. Old HRK. You're going to give this doggie a shake. You're going to get a chilled martini glass. Shake the fuck out of it. Shake it like you want to shake your girlfriend's fucking shoulders when she's screaming at you and you're like, I just want to sleep. Okay, anyways. Oh, man, put that lid on tight. Must be what my girlfriend feels like every time she tries to open some pickles. All right. I made one before, and I made it with Dubliner, and I shook it with the bacon in it, and the Dubliner was caramel, and it was just too sweet for me, and then the bacon just made it, like, kind of lumpy, so I took the bacon out this time. And listen, you know I don't believe in garnishes, but I'm going to garnish this motherfucker with a little strip of bacon, because I feel like the only garnish that is acceptable for a man to put in his drink is bacon. This will be the first time I've ever had this, so cheers, and let's see how she tastes. It is an interesting array. Like if I was what do you call those wine fucking nerds? A sommelier? Is that what you call that? I don't know. If I was one of those guys, you can like taste all the individual flavors. You can taste the apple. You can taste the syrup. You can taste the bacon. It's delicious. Great breakfast. Great breakfast martini. If you're a person who likes to have a martini at 6 a.m., this is the one I would recommend. Good. All right. So, like I said, we're talking about crazy exes. And what I did for you guys is I went ahead and I rated my top 5 crazy exes. So let's run through them. I'll be using fake names as to not give these hoes the satisfaction of me saying their names on my podcast. Number one, we'll call her, or number five. So this is like the least crazy of the most crazy because they're all fucking crazy. You know, don't fucking get it twisted. But this is the least crazy of the most crazy. And we didn't date very long, but it was a passionate, you know, 6 weeks. Could have literally been 6 days. I don't remember, but sure felt like fucking 6 weeks with this lunatic. And number five, we've got, we'll call her Mickey. Mickey with an M is her deal was this girl, like, we went on one date, and then the second date we kind of consummated the relationship, if you will. And she lived in the city, and I was working in the city, so I would stay at her place a lot. And then she came and stayed at my place. And first of all, we became like Instagram friends, and she started like tagging me in Instagram stuff and like tagging me in couples memes and shit. And I'm like, well, I mean, I don't know. Are we really a couple? Like, I don't know if we're super official yet. We've been on fucking two dates, Mickey. Not to be confused with Nikki, which is her real fucking name. That's the only one whose name I'll disclose, because she doesn't, like, we dated for fucking 3 weeks. So fucking Nikki, it's great girl, you know what I mean? But she starts fucking, like, going hard on, like, you know, it's like, to me, it's like pissing on a fire hydrant when you're a dog. It's like girls like to mark their territory, right? I got this other B who's a fucking lunatic, and I left her off the list because I don't even fucking feel like whatever, but, and she's probably she's amongst the craziest, but whatever. But she will go on a post that I'll make on social, like, I was friends with her on social media for a while, and she would, like, go on post and, like, be like, remember when we dated blah 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 and you blah blah blah, and I'm like, listen, cut that shit out. My point is, girls love to mark their territory on social media. This is my man, you know what I mean? And that's what this girl was doing hard. And then I had her come to my house. She brought Finn a bunch of stuff, like this grab bag of, like, hair products, because she worked in that field. And very nice. Listen, I'm not saying that was weird. That was just nice, you know what I mean? But then, like, she worked from home, so she worked from my house, and I fucking couldn't get this girl to leave. And I essentially, like, after like 3 days, I basically had to make it uncomfortable and be like, listen, you got to get the fuck out of here. Like, what? You got to go. I don't want to spend every day with you. We've been dating for fucking 2 weeks. So that's number five. And I spent too much time talking about that one. Number four, we'll call her Alejandra. I've told stories about her before, so I'm not going to spend a lot of time on this one. But this is the girl that went on my Bumble app while I was in the bathroom on a date. We weren't like official. We just like went on a date. And then we ended up dating, so that's why I'm counting her as an ex. But in this particular instance, the craziest thing she did was she went on my Bumble app and, like, messaged 20 girls on my Bumble app that I had matched with, that they were, like, ugly and kill yourself and all this real mean, nasty, dark, morbid shit. She was a fucking lunatic. Currently, if I'm not mistaken, in some kind of a Maury situation with, like, who's the baby daddy between a couple guys. I don't fucking know. Whatever. I don't have time for that shit. Number three, we'll call her Lamey. She was super fucking lame. And this fucking girl, first of all, she was just like a nerd. She was just a nerd. She didn't like to party. You know what I mean? I was a young kid. I had no business dating this bitch because she just was not fun. And I'm a fun, you know, listen, I'm not perfect, but I'm fun. This girl, I'm going to a bachelor party. And it's not like a hooker bachelor party. It's like, we're going down the city and we're going to play some poker or something. I don't fucking know. But it's like 7 o'clock. I'm leaving. Oh, I love that breakfast drink. It's like 7 o'clock. I'm leaving the house. I got to go into the city. It's like an hour drive. And she's like, you can just tell she's just fucking uneasy about the whole thing. I get on the road and she calls me and tells me that she cut her foot. She broke a glass and stepped on it and cut her foot super fucking bad. And it was bleeding everywhere. She needed to go to the hospital, blah, blah, blah. And I was like, well, listen, first of all, I don't fucking believe you. Like, I could tell by her voice. Like, I just knew this bitch was, the way she was acting before I left, and just my history with her, like, I knew this was bullshit. And then I was like, furthermore, like, I don't know how to administer stitches. You know what I mean? I'm not a nurse. You know, if I was, I would be crazy. And, you know, I would have never left because I'd be scared to leave you because I'd be a crazy fucking nurse. But anyways, so I didn't come home. I was like, I don't know what to go. Go. Well, take care of it. You know what I mean? You're a fucking grown woman. I went to my thing. I came back the next day because I stayed the night there because I got schmammed. And that was part of the plan, probably what made her so uneasy. And I was like, hey, let me see this foot I'm hearing so much about. And I knew that it was bullshit. And she was like, no, I'm not even showing you. You don't even care. It's just like, whatever. Like, no bandage on her. She didn't even, like, I would have at least faked a bandage. She didn't even do that. It's like, you know, you're so fucking bogus, man. Whatever. So that's Lamey. And then number two is Raquel. And, oh, man, this girl. Listen, first of all, great girl. You know what I mean? All these girls are great. But this girl, she loved me so much that she threatened to crash the car while we were both in it one time. We were fucking fighting. One time, I forget the scenario, but she wasn't supposed to, like, I didn't want her to come over. You know what I mean? I should have put coming over unannounced on the list. Fuck. If you've come over unannounced, that's another one. You're fucking crazy as fuck. You can't go somewhere like to surprise someone. You know, don't surprise someone. If you feel like someone doesn't want you to come around because they're with another person, then just break up with them. That's my advice. Whatever. But you can't come somewhere to surprise someone. Anyways, this girl wasn't supposed to come over, and I was trying to, like, distance. You know, the thing about crazy girls is they're hard to fucking break up with, you know? I pride myself on being easy to break up with. I fucking will tell girls on first dates that my best quality is, if you don't want to date me anymore, you can just tell me. No fucking sweat. I'm not going to be like, this isn't over. Like, I'm not going to, that's not my style. You know what I mean? I'm just like, I understand. Every time a girl breaks up with me, I'm just like, I get it. You know? So yeah, be easy to break up with. It's one of the best qualities in the world. I can tell you right now, like, if I tried to, I mean, I make jokes on this show a lot about how Ashley's crazy. I'm using the quotes. But like, if I tried to break up with Ashley, she'd be like, see you later, fucking loser. You know what I mean? She wouldn't, she's not the type to, like, you know, she, whatever. So, but this bitch, this crazy bitch, Raquel, also I shouldn't call her a bitch. She's a great lady. We dated a long time ago, but she was, so she threatened to crash the car once. There was another time where fucking, I was, I had an, she, we weren't supposed to hang out that night. And like I said, she was like, sometimes when you're seeing someone, like, they get a little, you, whatever, you just kind of get like, nah, you know, we were at the vast stage and we weren't like living together or anything. We were just dating. And I had my ex come pick me up. And fucking, we're like pulling out of the my condo that I lived in, and the girl that in question, like, passed us, you know what I mean, and she didn't see me because I saw her from like a while away, and I like ducked down. There's no way she saw me. That's my point. And there's no way she should have any idea what kind of car my ex drives. But she fucking loops around, follows us for like fucking 45 minutes down the highway. We're like halfway to fucking Kentucky. And this bitch is still behind us. And I got my seat laid back. Like, I took the seat way down so that she couldn't see me. She like gets next to this lady and she's like honking and like looking, and the girl that like my ex that I was like in the car with was just like looking straight ahead and like talking without moving her lips, like, this bitch is fucking nuts. And I'm like, I know, like, laying on the floorboard. so that's when I had to leave that girl like a thief in the night, dude. She like left for work, and I just like threw the bare minimum in my truck and disappeared. Moved to a new place, didn't tell her the address, whatever. She found the fucking address though and came and almost beat the fucking door down one day, which I didn't have on the list of notes here, but that's probably the craziest thing she's ever done. And then number one, oh mama, we'll just call her Beth. I don't fucking know. I'm tired of making names that sound like the actual names. This girl, first of all, she was a nurse. So we all know nurses are the fucking most crazy of every girl, of any girl that's ever lived. Yeah, nurses are nuts. So like, just like a list of things, like, she, one time I was trying to leave and we had a puppy at the time, and she put the puppy on top of the car. So I had to like get out of the car to, like, she wasn't letting me, she didn't want me to leave. And I was like, I gotta get the fuck away from you. You know what I mean? I was just trying to get away from this girl. She runs outside, puts the puppy on top of the car. Like, what, that's your move? So I like had to get out and like get the puppy and be like, here, take the puppy, or I'll take the puppy with me. I don't give a shit. You know what I mean? Whatever. And then, yeah, whatever. Like, that's a whole story. But the point is, don't put a puppy on a car, you fucking child. She, there was one time I was trying to leave a bar that, like, I don't know if we were out together. If I was, she would like Shanghai surprise me a lot in the bar, like just like show up when I was like out with my buddies, which, listen, that's a terrible thing to do. Don't do that. But one time she came to a bar that I was at and I like tried to leave. I was like, I'm getting the fuck out of here, man. And I went to leave and she stood behind my car so that I couldn't back out. So like, That's fine. I'll just like back out super fucking slow to kind of like push you out of the way. I mean, and then fucking cop drives by because it's a small town. And the cop's like fucking, and I've been drinking, but it's daytime, so the cop didn't fuck with me. And the cop's just like, what the fuck's going on here? And I'm like, I'm just trying to leave, man. This girl, what do you want me to do? This girl's standing behind my car. That can't be legal, can it? And then the cop made the bitch move and I got to leave. So that was nice of the cop. Good job. Our fucking heroes in blue. one time she sold all my, we broke up. This is a girl like I've had to look in the face 15 times and be like, I don't want to do this anymore. I'm not interested in this. But we were like on a lease together, so I had to like ride it out. Well, I got a new place and I moved, but like I was moving my stuff out slow, you know. She sold like half my shit on Craigslist and just kept the fucking money. She legit just like sold all my shit. One time I had this jacket and she came with me shopping for said jacket. And I said, hey, what do you think of this jacket? I think it's kind of cool. And she's like, oh, yeah, that's fucking awesome. Buy it. So I bought the jacket. She didn't buy it for me. I bought the jacket. But it was like a cool jacket. I looked good in it. It was fall time. It was jacket season. I was excited about this jacket. We either broke up or got in a fight or something. She takes the jacket and brings it to her friend's house and like puts it in the closet. And she's like, he's not wearing that jacket that I told him he looked good in. He wouldn't even have bought it if I wasn't there. Like, yes, I would have, bitch. You're dumb. But, you know, like, this is the kind of pettiness. And then, let's see. Oh, and then I told this story before, so I'll make this one quick. But one time I was on, like, a pub crawl where, like, we kind of just went all over. It's like a New Year's Day thing. And she called you. My point is, to find out where I was at, you would have to call 20 bars in 20 different towns. And she tracked me down, unbeknownst, like, didn't let me know she was coming, and fucking showed up. I was dancing with an 87-year-old woman, like slow dancing to an Elvis song, like being cute, not like trying to bang an 87-year-old. Her hair was legit blue. I'm not making this up. 87 years old. And the girl comes in and gets jealous of this little old lady. like she caught me. She was like, gotcha, bitch. I had to leave that night too. Yeah. So that, what would I call that girl? Beth? Yeah. Yeah, you're the worst. Probably great right now. Probably great with someone else. You know, so that's my point. Like, I'm not completely convinced that these women are crazy in every relationship they're in. But I've definitely had all 10 of those things happen to me. And I mean, all you girls are a little fucking crazy. And here's why I think, I understand, because here's why. Here's why women are crazy. Because they can't do anything to us physically. Like a girl, if a dude's checked out, if a dude doesn't want to be with you anymore, it makes you crazy, right? Because you still like him and he's just like ignoring you or laughing or rolling his eyes or acting like whatever. And, you know, a woman can't like hurt the guy. You know, she probably wants to fucking punch him in the face. If they did that, I mean, I've been punched in the face by a girl before. It's just like a nice punch for a girl. Like, good job. You know, you got me. Ooh, fucking lunatic. And then you just make fun of him. But you can't do anything to him. And I think that's what makes him crazy. And then they need to hurt you somehow because you hurt them. And I think that's what it's about. Now, I'm not a fucking psychologist, obviously. Can't even spell it. If I could be any kind of ologist, I'd probably be a gynecologist. And I'm not smart enough. So instead, I'm a comedian with a podcast who tends bar. Or a bartender with a podcast who does comedy. I'm not sure which. But the point is, like, I get it. I get where it comes from. And when I say the word crazy, it's like, you know, a lot of chicks get triggered by that word. It's just a word. It's just the best word to describe it. I'm not trying to haul anybody out. You know what I mean? I get why you hoes are crazy, you know? And any girl who's like, he makes me crazy. Well, I probably fucking did. So, you know, sorry. Yeah. Hey, tell you what, the top five girls in that list, I sincerely, from the bottom of my heart, apologize to all of you. Like I said, you were all great girls. They're probably all in successful relationships right now. With guys that do everything they say. My problem is I'm just not a guy that's going to do what somebody says. And that's what's so great about Ashley, because she only makes me do what she says like 4 days a month. It's the same 4 days every month. I'm starting to figure out which 4 days it is. And on those 4 days, I just work as directed. Piece of cake. Let's make this last call, folks. Last call! That's the least I've ever had in my drink at last call. So that's kind of fun. So with that, I don't know, man. This is old HRK signing off. Let's wrap this thing up. First of all, if you like to drink a martini before fucking 10 a.m., I highly suggest the Bacon Me Crazy that I just ran you through. It's easy to make. Doesn't require a lot of ingredients. If you got kids at the house, you probably got apple juice. Everybody's got generic syrup. And then you just need some vodka and some bacon. Second of all, you women are all a little fucking crazy. You know what I mean? Like I said, it's probably because you can't hurt us physically. So you got to hurt us, you know, any way you can. Fucking small caveat on that. Just keep in mind that we can't hurt you physically either. You know what I mean? Girls got it better because a girl can throw a fucking lamp at your face and just chalk it up to fucking hormones. You know what I mean? But every time I throw a girl down the stairs and try to blame it on Dynaball, I go to jail. So it's kind of fucking bullshit. You know what I mean? We can't hurt you physically either, you fucking assholes. But we somehow hold it together. anyways, my point is I understand why you get crazy. And this isn't an attack. It's a just admit that you're a little fucking nuts and, you know, we'll all accept each other for who we are. And then third, I don't fucking know, man. Third will be, happy fucking Mother's Day to your mom in particular. See you later. Thanks for listening to The Perfect Drink. Remember, you can always hear me first on Be Positive Radio every Monday at 1 p.m. If you miss me there, all episodes are available on YouTube, Apple Podcasts, Spotify, and anywhere else you might listen to your podcasts. Be sure to like, subscribe, and tell a friend. If you're interested in being a guest on the show or you just want to tell me how much you like me, feel free to send me an email at hrkpresents@gmail.com or just slide into my DMs like your mom does. See you next time.